Breaking big government bust in Vegas massacre with who gave shooter meds, here's why the story vanished. It's been a month and a half since the nation's largest mass shooting in modern history happened with more questions lingering than answers, until today. It's been strange, in the least, that a crime of mass casualty has been swept under the rug and all but forgotten as authorities and the mainstream media have abandoned the story altogether, seemingly hoping that the American people would move on. However, now it's become clear as to what the supposedly sloppy investigation has been hiding all along, and it's clear as to the reason why now that it's been revealed as who gave the shooter his medication and perhaps why. It's been known since the beginning shooter Stephen Paddock was on diazepam, which is a drug used to treat anxiety, muscle spasms, and seizures. The known side effects of this controlled substance, it's likely to cause paranoid or suicidal ideation and impair memory, judgment, and coordination. Paddock was a known drinker who often over-imbibed, which has particular damning effects on someone taking diazepam. Combining with other substances, particularly alcohol, can slow breathing and possibly lead to death, but can also dramatically increase the effects of the drug. So either Paddock was dishonest with his doctor about his alcohol use, abused the medication on purpose, or was prescribed this particular drug with an ulterior motive by the prescriber. Considering who gave it to, seems to suggest the letter as well as the reason why the government is so desperate to hide the details of this horrifying mass casualty case. SAT reports. The physician who last June prescribed accused Las Vegas shooter Stephen Paddock diazepam, a drug used to make some more hypno-suggestible or hypnotizable and induce amnesia, according to Las Vegas Review Journal and his doctor Stephen P. Winkler of Las Vegas, Nevada. Winkler is the chief medical officer of Nevada 1MOT, Disaster Medical Assistance Team. DMATs operate under the direction of the Department of Homeland Security, and Winkler is thus what is known as an intermittent federal employee and also serves on a number of professional committees. NV1MAT is also a division of Nevada's Clark County Emergency Management Agency, who just prior to the October 1, 2017 Las Vegas mass shooting, hosted at least one multi-agency mock mass casualty terrorism response exercise in Las Vegas. CIA codenamed MK-Ultra Mind Control programs experimented heavily with amnesia-inducing hypnosis, facilitated by certain drugs like diazepam. It's hard to believe that the very doctor who prescribed the shooter with the exact drug his group talked about using, and also staged the mass casualty even prior to the real thing happening, had nothing to do with this massacre. It raises a lot more questions as to who else was involved and exactly what they were trying to accomplish in the long run with this, but could answer why the story of this deadly incident seems to have disappeared. The question of government involvement has come up more than once, with one particular tie that Paddock had with government contractors that added a lot to the thickening plot last month. With this tie-in, things are getting even stranger. If you suspected a government involvement in the scrupulous planning that no average Joe is really capable of doing on his own, you were probably right. The mysterious Stephen Paddock is an average, faceless guy who blends into society despite being rather wealthy. Paddock had several investment properties and apparently at least one private plane, which ended up in unusual use after he reportedly sold it to an intelligence contractor who was part of Obama's administration. While that raises some eyebrows, what else was discovered about this alarming sale pretty much blows the investigation wide open as to why the FBI is protecting and even changing so many facts about this crucial incident that killed 59 Americans and wounded over 500 more. A few internet sleuths have taken matters into their own hands after the obvious disinformation campaign by the mainstream media surrounding the Las Vegas shooting, the Daily Sheeple reported. Before you board the skepticism train, the proof is in the information provided on via the FAA. Of course, this isn't something that CNN will be quick to expose, as it reveals the attack is worse than we thought and may not end with these 59 victims. My talk is limited to a certain character count in the written portion for the tweet, so his message only says so much. However, he lets the evidence he lays out say far more than what the site limits him to writing. It's now becoming more clear than ever that the government is hiding the facts from us to protect themselves. The Daily Sheeple explains what the evidence in this tweet means and is not looking good for Obama's administration. Not surprisingly, the former president is nowhere to be seen since initially trying to come out as a hero, pushing for gun control, of course. Looking closely, the first thing you will notice is that the shooter, Stephen Paddock, had a pilot license and owned two planes. This is well-established fact. The tail number of one of those planes is on 5343M, a Cirrus SR-20. You can see that this was owned by Paddock by going to the website flightaware.com. But Paddock doesn't own this plane anymore. It was grounded 3 years ago, and it's now in the hands of none other than Volant LLC, which there is little information on. However, Volant Associates is none other than a Department of Defense contractor. Meaning Paddock's plane has been in the hands of the United States government for the past 3 years and grounded since, if Volant LLC is being used as a way to hide information. Considering what Volant Associates does, that wouldn't be so far-fetched. But the plane's information is all easily verified here on FlightAware.com. It's been in Roanoke, Virginia since April 25, 2014. Volant describes its mission on their website as providing the industry's preeminent professionals to discriminating U.S. government and intelligence and defense industry customers. The registration of this plane is also listed as active even though it hasn't been flown in 3 years. Strange enough yet? Well, it gets even better. The FAA should have this same information. But they don't. Their website shows that a different aircraft, a Cessna 152, maintains that tail number and it was last registered to a person in San Diego, California. The FAA, Federal Aviation Administration, is a government agency, and it appears that it has scrubbed this plane's information. Now, why would they do that? Well, the plot still thickens. In the age of the internet, with every reputable business being represented by some kind of a website, it's strange that a contractor company successful enough to purchase an airplane is practically nowhere to be found online. The only plausible reason for this is something to hide, or perhaps Volant LLC is a cover company for the defense contractor. If so, inquiring minds want to know what they're trying to hide and why.